The Queen Woman has committed crimes against the Hamlet and its people, and will make sure it's got nothing to say in its defense. She's a boss that we've run into a number of times already, actually, but we've never once sat down to discuss what she, and she alone, means to our survival. So today, we change that. But first, we kinda need to know where to find the Queen Beast. And we must prepare for a jungle expedition, as we have to locate and dive deep into Mant Hills, their spawn point and cave structures among the rainforest biomes that are home to another exclusive Hamlet mob, Mants. Now, note that these hills will have a lot of tunnels and varying rooms in look, feel, and of course, residency. And I'm pretty sure that all the Mant Hills are actually connected. So you find one, you'll find them all. But really, all that matters for us today is finding the Queen Womat Den within these things. And something tells me you'll know it when you see it. Enter this horrifically welcoming structure to once again find more rooms to traverse, but there's a problem. Warrior mants. Regular mants only aggro upon you getting too close to them, but warrior mants ain't playing around and have more health, deal more damage, and are quicker than their distant cousins. Oh, and there's several more per room here too. However, with that in mind, I have found that immediately running to and sticking to the edges of these Womat rooms is enough to usually avoid any interaction with these humanoid insects. So I'd do that if I was you. Make it past 3 to 5 rooms of death, and, well, even more, bigger death will be awaiting ya. And if that's not the don't starve way, I don't know what is. But before we get to some murder methods, here's just a general tip. Give yourself some light for the fight, as you just really never know how long these are gonna take, whether or not you'll need to cook something on the fly, or if you're gonna need some help negating any of the sanity drain that's gonna be coming from these parts. So just light it up, even though you probably don't really need it. So, for this first bout, let's keep it basic, shall we? Grab 7 to 9 walls, do a little prep near the entrance, then rush to construct, and pray that luck is on your side. To start, she spawns 2 to 3 warrior eggs that, of course, will eventually hatch into mat warriors to help rough you up. But if you even just get one trapped behind your wall, you are golden. You see? You can kill the eggs before they hatch, and you could certainly just keep killing the mants as they come. But each round dead means another round spawned. So if you actually stop the murder, which I never tell you to do, you can stop the spawning. Once that's out of the question, all that is needed is to just smack her dead with your meats, as long as the raining rocks and mobs don't bonk you too much. For you see, she causes frequent earthquakes that could prove very troublesome, but can kinda be ignored for the most part now and then. The real issue are her pipes. Cause come her second phase, she grabs her tail and belts one out, rendering you pretty much useless for a time, although sometimes it varies. But more notably, it's always gonna knock you for 25 to 50 sanity with each blow. It's not great, but we will talk about negating that completely very soon. But for now, just know that she only has 3,500 health. So she really isn't gonna be too much of an issue herself. It's all the other crap you need to worry about. But once dead, though, I'm sure you'll have some stranglers to handle, but chances are your loot is also nowhere to be seen. But no worries, in one last jab to her wormy majesty, we can mine her throne to reveal all the goodies. The Queen Womat will drop 5 monster meats, 5 honey, 4 pieces of chitin, the royal crown, and even the blueprint for bundling wrap the boot. On top of that, mining the throne itself nets additional flint, niter, and rocks. So you're kind of walking out of here with quite the haul, especially considering some of the things from the earthquake might be up to grabs as well. And a good number of what we've just obtained is rather self-explanatory at this point in Don't Starve's history, but what about this chitin stuff? Well, For one, it can be combined with wood armor to assemble the Mant Suit, an armor piece with 450 durability that will actually just deteriorate over time while simply wearing it, but does offer an 80% reduction to physical damage while in combat. And that is not bad, actually. But why stop there? Join me and go the extra mile by creating what is known as a Mant Mask with more of this chitin stuff and a football helmet for a piece of headgear that also boasts 80% damage absorption but still sits at 450 durability. However, using these in combat is not the main draw of this potential combination. Put the two armors together, and you can take your rightful place as the Mant King, as normal Mants will now not become hostile upon your approach, which allows for some much safer navigation and potential gathering of all the loots down here. It's very nice when you're in the bowels of the insect beasts, but still be careful, as those Mant warriors are not gonna be fooled by this. But let's go further beyond with the Weevil Mantle by combining the carapace of yet another Hamlet exclusive insect with that of our pre-existing chitin. We can craft an armor that may only absorb 60% of damage taken, but offers the mighty respectable 900 durability overall, which makes it the second best in all of Hamlet. It's good. However, that low absorption rate may end up nipping you in the butt in the end if you ain't careful. And finally, even trading a piece of chitin to a collector within the Hamlets is gonna be fantastic, as it will result in 3 oinces each time. So there you go. Money and power all in one. And see? Murder does pan out well. However, combat and healing can be tough in Hamlet, so luck may not be enough in the end. So another method then could be simply getting a number of guard pigs to venture in with you to the Queen's Lair, only for them to do the heavy lifting, while you either sit back, clear the adds, lend a hand to speed things up, or in my case, just get your crap pushed in over and over again. Either way, great and all, and highly, highly advised. But recruiting guard pigs is not as easy as we've grown to know. For you see, food won't do you nothing. Instead, we must purchase or create a security contract via the town hall or the key to the city in order to then hire guards for our pleasure. It's pretty easy and inexpensive. Plus, guards will follow you for up to 2.5 days, so there you go. Oh, and to those who informed me to rush to her back and fight her there, well done. You want to talk needing next to no prep to finish her off? This is your method of doing so, right flipping here. The warriors will get stuck most of the time, just like the dum-dums they are. And it's really still just the earthquakes that are gonna give you the grief. That, and her still blowing ya. Wait, that's not what I meant. 2 things before we go. It's up to you whether or not you return the crown to the Queen Malfalfa for a royal gallery key, and thus the rewards that come with that, or whether you decide to keep the thing for yourself. It has no durability, but provides a constant +4.4 sanity per minute gain, so it is quite unique and could be mighty useful. But do keep in mind that you will need to hand it over to unlock Wilba too. And finally, if you manage to get rabbit earmuffs into Hamlet and down under in her den, you will benefit from no negative effects following her tail-blowing attack. Is it random? Sure seems like it. Is it gonna be worth it? Probably not. Is it useful? Heck yeah it is. But there you have it everyone, a guide on one of Hamlet's more simple bosses and what dethroning her means for you, as well as the Hamlet as a whole. Easy, but fun. Tame, but unique. And I say, very nice. Thanks for watching, folks. Well wishes to all, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.